Alright, everybody, it is 10 o'clock. It's me, your old pal Tim for GIZORAMA, the self-described Nintendo guy. As most of you may or may not have heard, Nintendo Japan President Satoru Iwata passed away over the weekend, or at least his passing was announced over the weekend. In his memory, I try to think of something, you know, appropriate to do to thank him for all the games and hardware he's brought us over the years. He worked with both HAL Laboratory and Nintendo. And in my research, I noticed that he's actually a producer on Kirby's Adventure, which I'm going to go ahead and say might actually be my favorite Nintendo game. It's a tall order, at least my favorite NES game. It's probably the only NES game I ever spent more time with than Super Mario Bros. 3, and considering the amount of time I sunk into Super Mario Bros. 3, that's saying an awful lot. So, without any further ado, Yes, me too, I'm weeping as well, Steinblatt, but without any further ado, I'd like to take everybody through Kirby's Adventure. I think these little interstitials here really show one of my favorite aspects of Kirby is just how much personality this game has. Luckily it came this late in the NES's life, so it had all sorts of technological advancements to sneak in all the extra frames of animation and all the various colors on screen, and everything's just so adorable and cartoony, even in hindsight, after, Jesus Christ, 22 years that this game's been out, there's still very few games I can think of that match it in just color and personality and texture. Mr. Gimmick being one of them. I don't know if anybody's played Mr. Gimmick for the NES, but it's probably the only NES game I would say can rival Kirby's Adventure, at least graphically. I don't know why I did that, I'm sorry. Kid, the Maxim tomato that I just picked up always kind of bummed me out because I've never liked tomatoes and I don't understand why they're Kirby's favorite food considering he can eat literally anything. Yes! Alright, that's probably the last time that's gonna happen tonight. Look at that adorable little UFO. Like, come on, that's exactly what I'm talking about. That's so cute. Alright, crane game. Everyone has to watch me do the crane game. When I was younger, and probably to this day, there's very few things I would have given to have had a doll of Kirby, all big and puffy and full of something like that. He always looks so pained when he's like that, it's like he's not enjoying carrying around all that food inside of him, I guess. Not only is a bottomless cosmic horror, I don't really think it should make a difference. You know, if I'm being honest, probably a big part of why I liked this game so much when I was younger was the how easy it was and how generous it was with lives. Like, I don't know what my problem was, but when I was a little kid, I always thought passwords were kind of for suckers. So if a game didn't have a save state, I probably wasn't going to beat it, which in the NES days was kind of a problem. It wasn't too bad when I got to the Super Nintendo. It's probably the only reason I beat Earthbound. It's a hell of a segue, I guess, talking more about Iwata. Earthbound is my other favorite game that Satoru Iwata was involved in. I don't know if anyone else has heard the story about how he had to salvage that game. Been working on it for about 4 years, and it was broken to the point where the map wouldn't function properly, and you couldn't actually navigate anywhere. Oh, I'm so embarrassed I missed that. And they sent Iwata down to help, and allegedly within a month he had it all straightened out. At least for Nintendo stuff and not so much HAL stuff, Iwata was always kind of Nintendo's, hey, we're gonna send you in to straighten this out kind of guy. Like, if a game was taking too long or if something wasn't working, they would send Iwata, and inevitably Iwata would get it all tidied up and working. Alright, it's a little overkill for three of those, face fly guys, but whatever, I'm not taking any chances. I always loved that. I always loved his weird little water spout attack. What? Alright, that tomato's gone. I'm over it. I'm moving on. Well, made it. Okay. Sorry about the mouse cursor, everybody. Ooh, sword guy. Yes! Alright, let's go for two. Aww, so close. Making good time, although in a game as easy as Kirby's Adventure, I suppose it's not saying a lot. Wow! Jinxed myself. Oh, what? Alright, nobody saw that. We're all gonna pretend like that last one didn't happen. You know, I really kind of feel like that's one of the things I might enjoy best about Kirby is the fact that the minute-to-minute gameplay is kind of a bizarre cross between Mega Man and Sonic, if that makes sense. Like, the second you take damage, your power is completely useless and you have to scramble to pick it back up, kind of like the rings. But you have so many more combat options, I guess, for lack of a better term. I'm hesitant to call anything as cute as Kirby combat-focused, but, I mean, I'm exploding adorable nightmare creatures using a fireballs and lasers and such, and I'm not really sure what to call it other than combat. Why do I think I could eat that? It eats everything else. That seems awfully fast. Maybe I'm missing something. I didn't see anything. Did you guys? Nah, I'm over it. Moving on. Ah! I'm getting one level lower each time. It's breaking my little heart. John, I'm sorry, I just saw your chat message, and you are absolutely right. Actually, he saved the map so hard that when he was finished reprogramming... God dang! When he was finished reprogramming Pokemon Gold and Silver, they had enough room left over to include the entire map from Red and Blue, along with many of the Pokemon from the first generation. Which, other than saving Earthbound in a month, is probably my favorite Iwata story. I understand he had a similar effect on the first Pokemon Stadium. Okay, I guess I should say the second Pokemon Stadium is the first one we got in America, was the second one in the series, and, okay, you know, whatever. But, I guess it was the same kind of thing. He was called in to import the battle system and strengths and weaknesses from Pokemon Red and Blue, and he was the only guy at Nintendo that could figure out how to do it. I was actually talking about this earlier today with a friend of mine for his podcast. I seem to have become an Iwata expert recently, and I've got mixed feelings about that, admittedly. Wait, the invincibility lollipop! Sorry, everybody, that's probably one of my favorite songs from the NES era. But no, I was talking about it earlier with a friend of mine for his podcast, and I've always kind of gotten the impression that if Iwata was called in to work on your game, it was probably considered something of a relief, because if you were trying to make something for Nintendo, and they sent Iwata down to help out, it probably meant your game wasn't going too well, but it meant everything was going to be fine in a matter of moments. Nope. Ah! I suppose I deserve that. This is sort of cheap. Kirby tradition of keeping the bosses in basically the exact same order in every game. Did anybody here play the one for the Super Nintendo, Kirby's Dream Land 3? When you're fighting Wispy Woods here, after a certain point he gets up and starts chasing you around in his scary little root feet, and he's making like a horrible mouth face, and it was basically my worst nightmare as a child. I had a lot of really specific fears growing up. Speaking of other Kirby fun facts, something has just come to mind. There was a presentation Iwata gave, I want to say around 2011, 2012, wasn't that long ago, where he admitted that during the development phase, one of Kirby's earlier proposed names was Twinkle Popo, which I guess is not out of the question considering the Lolo-Lala naming convention, but I can't help but feel as though that would have gotten changed for America anyway, and then everyone could still gripe about Kirby making angry eyebrows on the cover of every game. Although the idea of me doing a live stream right now of Twinkle Popo's adventure is kind of perversely hilarious. Ah! Should have done something about this sooner, I thought you didn't have to be touching the ground. Wait! Wait! There we go. Hey, I want to be a tornado. Oh, wait. Darn. You know, for the amount of times I've said that, you'd feel like I've never actually played Kirby's Adventure before, and I promise you guys I have. It's apparently just been a minute. Some things don't quite stay with you after 27 long years on this earth, and among them are how Kirby works. Ah. What's up here? What's up here? Oh, it's the egg catcher game. Let's just watch Kirby endlessly inhale eggs in a wrestling ring. Oh! I had such a perfect egg streak going, too. I didn't. I was nowhere near perfect. I hope everyone else understands my confusion as to why I was just shocked and baffled when people tried telling me that King Dedede was supposed to be a penguin later in life. I guess I can see it now that he's more than two colors, but right now I guess I never really knew what I assumed he looked like. But, you know, had you told me when I was younger that he was supposed to be a penguin in a bathrobe, I'd have probably gone with it. I didn't really have any reason to argue that. Yes. Oh, wait, I have to fight the wheel guy down here. I'm not using Spark. I could turn around first. There we go. Hey, Chuck. Aw, lame. Alright, we're doing this again. Yeah, basically, it's either a vinyl record or some kind of inner tube. Oh, I blew that one. Oh. You know, You know, maybe I just haven't marathoned it like this in a while, but it really is kind of striking to me exactly how short the levels in Kirby's Adventure are, and I mean that in the absolute best way. Like, Iwata said one of the guiding principles behind the entire Kirby series, and this kind of explains why the first game on the Game Boy Advance was some 5-6 levels long and extremely easy, is that he wanted it to consist of abstract characters with simple gameplay that anybody could understand basically immediately. Like, Kirby, I remember a lot of reviews back in the day kind of lambasting it for being too easy or kind of for kids. And at the point where this came out, yeah, the NES was sort of the system you'd already handed down to your little sister or whatever, and they were trying to make games that would appeal to even younger kids than usual. But Kirby specifically, Iwata's goal was always just to make them easy and accessible so that anybody who wasn't familiar with games can still play Kirby and kind of understand what's happening. I would say even the more recent games kind of get into that, honestly. Like, if you show Kirby Triple Deluxe to, like, a little kid who's probably never played Kirby before, it'll still... I don't know what I thought that was going to do, and I'm sorry. I'm too busy reminiscing over here, I guess. No, that's an excuse. I'm just not good at video games. Don't tell anyone. What was I saying? Something about Kirby, probably. It's great, and Iwata did a great job. He was only the producer. I don't really want to overstate things. He was certainly instrumental in the whole process, but I'm not going to go around trying to tell people that Satoru Iwata was Kirby's original character designer. Still, he was a big help, and without him, we'd be missing an awful lot of things from the Nintendo library. The DS, mostly. I'm always so disappointed you can't get any, powers from those guys. I want to eat that scary fork dude. What is his story? Alright, have me some bottled water underwater. That's cool. Yeah, look at that rippling water texture for a second. There's not a lot of NES games that would even bother with stuff like that. Wait, can I go down there? Ah, jerks. Nope. That's gonna kill me. I can't go down there. I'm glad I caught it this time. Alright, 5, I'll take it. It's better than 8. Today, I can safely say, is not my best playthrough of Kirby's Adventure. Yes, a land full of spoons where he was shunned for daring to stab things with his utensil and also have, like, scary samurai mask face. You know, the more I think about it, the more this may have been, my first exposure to crane games. I don't actually think I ever played a crane machine until after I'd played Kirby's Adventure as a child. I don't know if I'd have ever tried crane games had I not had this exposure to them first, frankly. Now, is that crane fever like Pac-Man fever, or is that crane fever like it was a sick bird? Where am I going? Ooh, the museum! Eat the one you want! That's sick. Give me this laser, though. Laser's the pro's choice. Laser, UFO, and microphone are probably my favorite powers in this game. Of course, now that I've said that, I've jinxed myself, and I'm gonna lose this thing in a matter of seconds. Look, man, what can I say? I didn't come from a town that had a ton of crane machines. Actually, the only one I can really think of, there was one in the arcade next to the crappy Sega Time Traveler game, that weird hologram one. And, I'm pretty sure there was one at Denny's. Years later, they would put one in at Kmart, and I would win a stuffed Peter Venkman doll out of it. One of my favorite and only memories of crane machines that aren't Kirby-related, I guess. One day I'm gonna go somewhere and I'm gonna find an actual crane machine with Kirby's in it, and I'll be able to die happy, and it'll be everything I'd ever wanted and hoped for. Okay, this is usually a boss fight. Yes, it's the scary alarm clock guy! Oh yeah, that hologram game looks like crap when you're older, but you know, when you're a kid, you think it's the future. It's literally the future, because it's time traveling, and you get it. Nah, you know what? I'm out of here. See, this is one of my favorite things about Kirby, and I know I've said that about a ton of things. It's probably because I have a ton of favorite things about Kirby. But the fact that the levels are designed so specifically to kind of encourage you to use certain powers and to really foster kind of a sense of exploration, you know, like... I honestly feel like a lot of the work on Kirby's Adventure, it came out later, but I feel like a lot of the work on Kirby's Adventure is really similar to what they were trying to do in Mario World, just as far as really wanting you to take a look around and check down hidden pathways or whatever. Luckily, none of them require you to find the hidden doors, like the Forest of Illusion, which is bullcrap, but I'll save that for another stream when I get mad about Mario World. And rest assured, dear audience, it'll probably happen. I have designated myself, and my associates agree that I have to be Gizorama's Nintendo guy. So if I do another stream at any point, you can rest assured they'll be getting mad at Mario eventually. Alright, let's check out the arena, this horrible Roman gladiator coliseum for... I guess Dream Warriors is what you'd call them, but that's the title of my favorite Nightmare on Elm Street. Sorry, Mr. Pants Wallace, that was really one-sided. Nobody make a Wilford Brimley joke, I'm gonna be so disappointed. Ah, lame! Come on! Yes! Who put an umbrella on that? Don't answer that. Wait, wait! Yes! Wait, I'm going down there, hang on. See, this is exactly what I'm talking about. I could have just looked down there sooner, but here we are. Oh, what? Nailed it, okay. I was afraid I was gonna be a little big for it. Alright, all that effort for a bottle of water. I don't know, I've gone through similar trials and tribulations for an overpriced bottle of water. I guess it's, not too different from going to festivals. I don't need the cape guy. You can go through one of these, I think. Or not. Guess who's just making stuff up, everybody? It's me. Check out Gizorama's retro gaming stream if you want to learn incorrect Kirby fun facts. Wait, I found. And promptly made an idiot of myself. Why did I come in here? You know what? I bet I'm supposed to have that fireball for some reason later. Try this again. Let's just leave, that's fine. Oh, all that hard work and for nothing. Didn't need that fireball, everybody. My estimations were grossly erroneous. Hey. Oh! I tried to pick up the tomato and instead fell to my death. I'm deeply ashamed. Oh, the music in this is all fantastic. Like, these songs have stuck with me for decades. Can we talk for a second about how I'm not even doing particularly well, and I have 15 lives? Like, it's starting to look like New Super Mario Bros. In here. I mean that in the best way. I like most of the New Super Mario Bros. Games. No, I don't actually need to go anywhere else. Alright, No, it's not Krakow, it's the painter guy. Nope, wait, get back up there. Alright, give me this toy car. I've always wondered who this guy's supposed to be. I kind of assume he's from another HAL game, because I feel like any of the bosses in this I don't recognize turned out to be from other HAL games. Chuck, how does anyone have 93 continues in Catherine? That's ridiculous. Alright, we're gonna digress from the Kirby talk for a second. I was trying to play Catherine, right? I had the Xbox 360 version. The whole game, the whole time, is telling you, like, oh, it's 7 days till the time of freedom. It's only going to be 7 days. So I'm thinking, yeah, okay, this game takes place over a week. So I beat the seventh night. It takes me forever. I'm feeling pretty good about myself all the same. I'm like, okay, there's an eighth night. Maybe it's just going to be, like, one big scary boss level, and I don't have to play Catherine anymore. I get to the eighth night, and it's, like, twice as long as any of the other nights, and I just turn my Xbox off and walk away. I, to this day, have never beaten Catherine, and I sincerely doubt I'm ever going to. Come on! There we go. The noise haunts me. It sounds exactly like a sound Kirby would make if he had to talk. I was really glad, like, the cartoon or anything never tried to assign Kirby a voice. I didn't like it when Yoshi started repeating his name over and over again. I'm glad Kirby kind of doesn't have that problem. Yeah, Chuck, don't bother with Night 8. It's just wacky. Oh, so close. Alright, so we've talked about Catherine, we've talked about Kirby. I suppose now the theme of the night is games that take place in dreams or some kind of dream world. How does everyone feel about Nights? Big fan of Nights. Man, I'd stream that if I wasn't so embarrassed to have other people watch me play it. I'm just bad at it. Aw. Ah, God! Keeps happening! Kirby, please turn around. I know, I'm blaming you for something I did, and I'm sorry. That's really unfair of me, Kirby. Alright. Don't need that wheel. See if I can bank these anywhere. Sometimes you can bounce these off curved platforms. Fireballs it is, thanks. Why did the tomato... Oh, okay, never mind. Video games, I understand. Look at this building rotate, man. This is some... It's like some Sega Genesis stuff. There's that level in Dynamite Heady that is all basically that gimmick, and it's awesome. I'm gonna go ahead and assume we probably have Iwata to thank for that. That's the sort of detail he always liked including. You know what else I found out in my exercise? Or my research, rather. Yes, my exercise. My reading exercise about Nintendo presidents. Is that, Iwata apparently worked on New Ghostbusters 2, which, if you've talked to me for any length of time, you know how much I like Ghostbusters, and you know how much I specifically liked that game. It's kind of insane to think that a dude who worked on a movie game in the late 80s would eventually become president of Nintendo, but hey, here we are. What's the weird penguins? I need some of that penguin action. Wait. Okay. Nailed it. Alright. Nope! No. Nope, nope! Man, I blew that. Nobody tell anyone. I'm gonna have to entrust you guys with an awful lot of secrets about me being secretly bad at Kirby. Oh, there it goes. Yeah, wait, Inkrap, have you never played Kirby's Adventure? That's a huge problem, man. I'm a big fan. Nope. Come on, come on. They're trying to suplex me and shoot more ladybugs. Yeah! Oh, this is one of my favorite ones because it's kind of not useful, but it's hilarious looking. Okay, I'm doing alright on this. Does anyone remember how many lives I've lost so far? It's just the one, right? It's about to be two, considering my woefully low health. Oh, it's like I just stood there and waited for it. I've lost my ability to take people to Suplex City, but I've got a clean bill of health. Alright, going down. I like that weird cape owl guy. What do you suppose he is? What do you suppose any of these things are? Kirby's character design is great because they're all, like, recognizable shapes, but they don't seem to be any one thing in particular. Like, if you had to describe Kirby to someone, what exactly would you tell them he is? I mean, other than an ancient Lovecraftian horror that will consume all in his path. Alright, back on this popsicle train. It's gonna be one of these levels. It's gonna be some Scooby-Doo hallway chase where I keep popping into doorways and appearing in other ones. Yeah, I'm just gonna commit. Alright, pin marshmallow with shoes, I'll take that. I feel like that's as close to accurate as anyone's going to get when attempting to tell someone who doesn't know about Kirby about Kirby. Hey, alright. That could have gone worse. You know what I should do sometime? I really need to look up who did the level design for this and just find other games they've played. The level design in Kirby is absolutely fantastic. It's just big enough to keep you interested, but you're not going to get lost like you will in, like, I don't know, some of the later Sonic games. As much as I love Sonic 3, those levels are enormous. It was a big problem around this time. This was a 1993 game, and I feel like the trend at that point was just to make your levels as huge as possible, at least as big as you could for a side-scroller, as your game invariably was. Oh, we have to do that, Skull Axe. Alright. Oh, he can just stay there, that's fine. What do you suppose that is? Some kind of robot duck? I don't know, maybe I'm grasping at straws here. Alright, Kirby, let's make your hollow weightnesses work for you. Ah, weak. Ooh, shooting game. Watch, everyone, I'm only gonna get so far in this one. I don't think there's been a point in my life where I've completed every round in this. Ugh, 17 seconds, I'm getting old. Oh, God. Hey, I was wearing one of those hats earlier. Taking this a little personally now, you guys. You know what? I have gotten that before, if you'd believe. I was apparently so stunned by your boyfriend's vocal comparison that I got shot. I don't blame him, though. Wait, you gotta use your hands? That's a baby's toy! I'm sorry, everyone. I'm getting to the point tonight where I make Back to the Future jokes. See, you don't get the invincibility lollipop that often, but when you do, you actually get the chance to use it. I'd much prefer that to just picking up, like, Starmans every 10 feet. I've chosen to abbreviate that as Starmans, everyone. I'm not sorry for the way I live my life. Nintendo and monkeys, man, I'm telling you. Or apes. Is this an ape? Honest to God, I've never been sure what the difference is. I have been told a basic understanding of animals. Hey, anytime. I'm super happy we're both going for the same Back to the Future joke. Played this level already. I feel like there's been at least one other one that starts just like that. Oh, awesome. This kind of stuff will never fail to impress me. You know what? I feel like in another world there would have been some pretty mediocre NES shooter where the entire gimmick of the game was that you could bounce your lasers around, and yet in Kirby, it's entirely possible to play this game and never actually eat that guy's power. Kirby, I think, almost more than a lot of other NES games, and there's several of them you could say this about, but I feel like Kirby almost has too many ideas. Like, I can only imagine how excited everybody was working on this game. Iwata, and I believe the creator of Smash Brothers was involved in the early Kirby games as well. I've always heard people griping about Kirby being overpowered in Smash Brothers, and I suppose it's only fair considering how involved HAL is with both of them. Also, I totally just ate crap on that one. Alright. Ah! Rocks! Why? Why, rocks? Some Demon Souls crap. I'm minding my own business, and there's just boulders out of nowhere. And this is worse, it's cute boulders with faces. Alright, see? Light. I'm only ever gonna use that power in this one room, and it's never gonna make a difference, and I love that. Ah! Yeah, you know, it's like the one in Mega Man 3, but better. Alright, looks like I'm peeking at 2, everybody. I am consistently second place, and I'm willing to accept this. Alright, going in. This one might be Krakow, I don't remember. Okay, it's the sun and the moon. I don't remember where Krakow is. He's in this game, I swear. I guess I just like saying Krakow. Oh. I took a stupid risk, and it didn't pay off. Alright, we're doing this again. Don't you Hadouken me? What is that? Sundouken? Okay, I'm sorry. I'm not gonna try to turn that into a joke. Some things just shouldn't be jokes. So we're in agreement that these guys can totally beat up the angry son from Mario 3, right? Like, these guys have limbs. The angry son in Mario just has, like, a poopy grimace. Yeah! Take that, the sun! Not the first time I've said that today. It was very hot, and I do not enjoy being outdoors that long. Oh! Alright, apparently this is the point in the evening where I'm going to start peeking in my Kirby ability. Also, my ability to pronounce things. Did anyone else just hear me sneak a V into the word ability? See, that's why you can't let kids play Street Fighter. It's a, violent influence on their behavior. Wow, that went way better. Oh, weak. Don't do that. Alright, jerk son, come on. What? Did that hit? Okay. Alright, so, Kirby's Adventure spoilers. I'm going around collecting the pieces of the Star Rod, right? And it didn't really dawn on me when I was a little kid and I played this, but King Dedede isn't really the bad guy in this game, and I don't say that because at the end of the game you have to fight some kind of, like, big anime Dracula, and that is exactly what happens. But it's kind of implied that the only thing keeping the big anime Dracula trapped was the fact the Star Rod wasn't put back in the Dreams Fountain or whatever. So it really kind of blew my mind when I was older to think about how I should not have been doing any of the things in this game. Like, Kirby's kind of just making his own problems right now. Kirby's got a nasty habit of assuming King Dedede did everything. There are several games where Kirby discovers a problem and just goes to beat up on Dedede for a while because he just assumes it was him because it was him the one time. It's a little unfair, but then I suppose I don't expect Kirby to show a lot of critical judgment in such matters. Okay, look at how cute I am right now. Holy crap. This is the best. It's my favorite Kirby mode. This is the Kirby equivalent of that part in Mario 3 where you pick up the shoe and you're bouncing around in it. Except this is way sweeter because I'm a UFO that shoots stars and lasers. Oh no! No! You get back here! Well, hoist by my own petard. I think it's actually a pretty good description of... I do not want the ball at all. I think it's a pretty good description of Kirby's difficulty in that, as you guys have seen, most of the times I've died have kind of been because I did something pinheaded, or I just wasn't paying attention, you know? Like, sure, it's a little easier than most NES games, but most NES games are also super unfair and kind of don't give a crap if you're having fun or not. So I guess if Iwata had to make the decision to make Kirby a little on the easy side just so people could actually play it and enjoy it after years of stuff like Legacy of the Wizard and Ninja Gaiden, and so be it. I think you made the right call. Come on! How are you immune to lasers as a tornado? I'm not a scientist, but I feel like there's something off about that. Of course, I'm also playing as a game where I'm an ancient puffball fighting his way through a dream world, so I can't really be too mad about scientific inaccuracies. I think this is my favorite background music in the whole game, honestly. At least for world maps. The instrument choice in this game, something about them has always been super impressive to me. Like, this sounds so much better than most NES games that use, like, the regular sound chip. I mean, yeah, Mr. Gimmick and Castlevania 3 have, like, fancy extra hardware for extra and better sound, but I suppose it's not really fair to compare the two. Alright, come get me. That worked. I like Spark because it's kind of powerful, but I hate Spark because you have to hold completely still. And I mean by kind of powerful, obviously everything in this game poofs away with one hit, but you can kind of keep it going indefinitely and things can just walk into it eventually. Because the Kirby bad guy AI is programmed to just kind of hop cheerfully over to you until you explode it. Maybe they don't perceive Kirby as a threat. I suppose I wouldn't if I didn't know any better. At least not until that horrifying Kirby... It was either for Kirby's Adventure or Kirby Superstar commercial where he eats a biker or something. It's hard to describe. There's like a big muscular guy there and the narrators talk about how tough this dude is and then Kirby eats the dude and it's weird. You know, video game ads in the 90s were weird by and large, but I feel like Nintendo especially missed the plot at that point. Oh, I know your tricks, double spikes. I'm not going up there. I don't need this. Some Mario Brothers 3 stuff. I brought up that game a lot, and I think it's kind of important to mention just because of that, and that and this were really sort of the landmark NES games for me. I was born a little later, so I missed a lot of the early going things. So, like, the majority of my Nintendo memories are, like, this, Mario 3, and, like, Mega Man 5. Which I stood up for in a recent article, and some guy got real mad at me because I didn't like Mega Man 3 as much as everyone else does, and it broke my little heart. Oh, I don't know what I was expecting to happen. Has anybody else here ever played any of the Persona games? Do these guys kind of remind anyone else of their Jack Frost icon? It doesn't have the same little, like, pointy tooth gap, but it looks really similar to me. Perhaps I'm projecting. Woo! Oh, look at that little clamber up there. I only know what the word clamber means because of the game Ghost Hunter. That weird British PS2 game with the guy that played Pinky from Pinky and the Brain. That game's fun. I should do a stream of that sometime so that way everybody knows what I'm talking about. Alright, 17 milliseconds? I'm not doing so good. Okay, I've never beaten Captain Monkey. This is gonna go real bad. Wait! I beat Captain Monkey, you guys! Oh. Oh, I blew it. I was too excited to shoot DDD. Yep, there we go. It was a matter of time, folks. You know, since most of this stream has just been me telling everybody things I really like about Kirby's Adventure, and that's a long list, friends. I really like that on the world map, everything is kind of telegraphed as far as, like, what the level's gonna look like. You know, I don't know if anybody noticed, but in the Butter Building, all of the levels were set on top of each other because you were climbing up the tower, and this one kind of hinted at the fact it was going to be Zeppelin-based on the actual, like, world map and the level select screen. Again, that's something I feel like Super Mario World did pretty well, and it's interesting to see them kind of trying to attempt that same level of detail on the NES, which at this point had been around for damn near 7 or 8 years. A little more in Japan. I can't help but feel like there's another door. Of course, the last time I had that same inkling of a thought... it just didn't work out. This time, it killed me. I want this to be a lesson to everybody about getting curious about anything. It's just not worth it, Kirby. Okay, I'll take it. Wait, yes, that's right, because... Oh, boo! I figured out what I was trying to do, and now I can't do it, you guys. Ah, whatever. No, you don't. Oh, it's sputtering against the high winds. God only knows where I've landed. Give me that laser! Blinking and color of the doors indicates something. I think it's trying to tell me that there's like a secret exit or something I didn't find. Admittedly, I've never really been the sort of dude concerned with finding secret exits because I'm way too impatient. I just like, you know, finishing the game or whatever. There are so many games that I have finished getting, you know, like 60% out of 100 just because I didn't stop and look for every stupid banana in Donkey Kong Country or something. No. Alright. Still blimps, I guess. That's fine. Okay, I'm just going around them. I hate those little face guys. Do you guys know what happens when you try to eat one of those little face guys? I'm gonna do it just so you see how horrible it is. Yes, that. Luckily, it explodes after a while. It's not like the mask in Mario 2 that chases you forever while you're holding the key. If I remembered how to jump high enough. Take this baby out for a joyride. By this baby, I guess I mean Kirby, and this got really weird, and I apologize. Whoa, hey! Yes! I have accomplished that maybe twice in my life prior to this, and I'm happy to have had witnesses despite all the other things I've screwed up in this particular Kirby game. Look at the happy turtle. Uh-oh. Guys, the turtle is a martial arts master. I was deceived by its buck tooth. Ah, screw it. Alright, turtle, what do you give me? Oh yeah, throw! It's like body slam, but it goes towards the other bad guys. Yes, look at how awesome that is. Does a little javelin pirouette. Suplex City, population, King Dedede. This is another one of those power-ups that you only see really once or twice in this game, so let's see how long I can keep this thing around without totally blowing it. Still gonna pass on the arena. And here we go. Yeah, see, that's what I'm talking about. Did you guys see how the backdrop to this level is kind of a castle, and now I'm kind of in a castle? I don't know, I've always appreciated stuff like that. It made me feel like I was actually going somewhere in a game as opposed to just picking dots and squares on a map. Or just blindly wobbling level to level like so many games have you do. Sure, let's see what's in here. I was just thinking to myself how I could do that throw thing all day, and thank goodness, because bad guys in this reappear the second you leave the screen. Which rules and sucks, because it means you get a second chance at some powers, but if you ever have to backtrack through an area, it's gonna be the same five Easter Island heads waiting for you. Oh, it's these clowns again. I don't know if I can throw them. Let's see if this works. Oh, that's awesome. I can't believe I never tried that before. Oh, why does he get spears? Okay. Oh, I'm so mad about that, you guys. I'm furious. I'm sure you can tell by my voice. Oh. Alright. Sure, it's better than nothing. Get right through your stupid apple. Take that. Wait. Oh. Here I thought I was being so clever. Pride goeth before the Kirby, I guess. Don't worry, folks, I'm surprised that worked out too. To the top of the castle, and I'm sure I'm about to die horribly with my one pip left. Oh, that worked. I forgot that worked. Water. Alright, Kirby handles better in water than most other video game characters, but it's still not great. I suppose it's preferable to the legions of Assassin's Creed characters that can't swim for whatever reason. Oh, it's you. It took me a long time to realize his little mustache is supposed to be like clock hands. Oh, it's this again. Oh, okay, I'm moving on. Dang it! You know what? Sword time. Okay, I guess I don't get the sword. Thanks, jerk. Like, his name is, like, Cutter Joe or something. All of the bad guys in Kirby have actual names, and that has always blown my mind. I only know many of them because of Kirby's Avalanche, actually, the puzzle game. Wait. There we go. I remember how some of this works. I'm sure I was well into my teen years before I figured out how that one was supposed to work. I mean, I'm stuck being a rock. Not even the rock, just a rock. I suppose it took care of my problems. Yeah, okay, five, I guess. Hey, it's Krakko! I finally found Krakko, you guys! I don't have to keep saying Krakko! No, get away from me! Okay, if anybody out there after this feels motivated to play Kirby's Adventure on their own, do not try and attempt this level without having the high jump power. At least until you, before you get to Krakko, because it is just frustrating and embarrassing. Now that I have high jump, I can just keep popping up and punching Krakko right in his eye, but before that. Now speaking from recent experience, I have this on the 3DS as well as the original Nintendo cartridge. And it took me quite a few tries to beat Krakko. Maybe that's my weird hang-up on Krakko. He's haunted me since childhood. Well, anyway, guys, thanks so much. This has been fun, but I've subjected everyone to 4 straight levels of Kirby. It's been going on for about an hour. I think we're good here. I'd really like to thank everybody for coming out and watching it. If you're watching this later after the fact, I'd really like to thank you for taking the time out of your day to watch a pre-recorded stream. I guess in kind of a slightly more serious note, I am super happy about Satoru Iwata's involvement in the game industry. I'm happy that I was able to play games that he'd had some hand in creating and use systems and hardware that he'd shepherded into existence. You know, he was very much responsible for the initiative behind the Wii and the DS and everything. It's a shame he's gone. I'm sorry he won't be around to work on any more games, and perhaps I'm biased, but I'm certain Nintendo will apply many of the lessons they took from his tenure going forward, and I'm sure whatever they come out with next will be great. That said, I'm actually super excited about whatever the NX is going to be, mostly because now it turns out it's Iwata's last console. So, in the words of a letter from Earthbound creator Shigesato Itoi, written about Iwata's passing, I'll see you all again soon. Thank you so much for Gizorama Magazine. This has been Tim. I will see you all later.